Good evening, brothers and sisters. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, in-laws and outlaws. If climate change were small change, we would be exchanging tips tonight. The delegates meeting at Bella Center believe that climate change is small change. And so they are busy exchanging tips under the table, meeting behind closed doors, making deals that would not solve the climate problem. I believe that the Climate Forum is the place where we have real people talking about their real problem, building real movement, and getting ready to share the solutions and to get on the streets and to knock on doors when necessary and make it happen that our policymakers will not get away with playing politics with climate change.
Yeah.
Somebody said climate change is not the change we need, and I believe that's the truth. I come from a part of the world, the center of the world. Africa is the center of the world. But we also stay in the center of the world where all the problems keep falling upon that continent. Africa has not contributed much to the store of carbon in the atmosphere, but the most impacts are inflicted upon the continent. This is why we meet together as social movements, as environmentalists, and insist on climate justice now. In Press of Aid International, which I'm sure you know about, 77 autonomous groups in 77 countries, working at grassroots level, working with the people who are really impacted by climate change and by all the impacts of global capitalism. We are driven by three key words, and I would like to repeat them after me. The first word is mobilize. Number two is resist. And to transform. Resist, mobilize, transform. These three key words capture what we stand for, how we work, and what we're looking for. As you heard from Henry, who just finished speaking, there have been serious land issues around the world. You've heard about land grabs. You've heard about ocean grabs. Now we're talking about the sky grabs. And we are saying that all this grabbing is enough. This grabbing has to stop. Polluters must be held to account. Unfortunately, some of us are both in the global south and the global north. But the issues of climate change and climate justice demand that those who have taken up the global commons should pay for the mitigation, should pay for building of resilience in the global south, and should pay for transfer of technology from the corrupting, polluting, fossil fuel-driven technology to one that is low carbon and that is green. And as you may know, if I start to talk about crude oil, my blood begins to boil. Because crude oil has made the world believe that we should not look for a solution to global warming. People say that crude oil is an easy and cheap form of energy, but it's not the truth. Crude oil may be cheap. It's only because people are not paying the price of crude oil. If you see what is going on in the fields, in the oil fields, the pollution, the degradation, the human rights abuses, the murders and the killings, I would like you to tell me how much one drop of oil should cost. The price of oil...
Wow.
We believe that the world has drilled itself into a tight corner, and more drilling will not solve the problem. Somebody once said that the world, The Stone Age did not end because of lack of stones. And so the crude oil age does not have to wait until crude oil is exhausted before it ends. It is time for us to insist that our policymakers must agree that 40% cut in emissions at home, at source, must not include anything like offsetting. But offsetting is really very upsetting. You cannot run a polluting industry somewhere else in the world and then offset it somewhere else in the world. It just doesn't jive. This is kind of fiction that must be exposed. And policymakers must stop to listen to industry and listen to people and hear what we're saying. Yeah. I believe that this is why we're in climate forum. To say the truth, insist on the truth, and dig into the ears of our policymakers. They just have to hear the truth. I issue tonight a red card to red. Because red is bringing misery. We all agree that deforestation must be stopped. But you cannot buy a forest somewhere in Africa, somewhere in Latin America, somewhere in Asia, drive your community people, and manage it in a way that you can get carbon credit. It doesn't just make sense. We have to stop pollution at source, fight climate change at source, change the way we behave, change the way we consume things, and begin to understand that we have just one planet Earth. You know what? I believe it was in the month of September, October, the United States bombed the moon. You can bomb the moon all you want, but the moon would never become planet Earth. As I was saying, crude oil, dirty energy is not the way for tomorrow. You know, policymakers make me think that they just are so short-sighted, many of them, not all of them. They're thinking about quick, short solutions. They're believing maybe their life is exhausted. They don't care about the children and the grandchildren, those who are coming after us. But we are here to say that climate change is not just a problem confronting us today. It's a problem that's going to be worse tomorrow if nothing is done today. And so we are saying, I will not be tired of saying this, and I'm going to ask you to help me say it. Leave the oil in the soil. Leave the coal in the hole. Leave the tar sand in the land. These forms of energy, these sources of energy, are just the road to destruction. And we have to stop now to pause, and I believe that these 2 weeks, with all the discussion we're going to have here, all the actions, all the meetings, we're going to build a concrete solution and force our decision makers to understand that making a political deal at Bella Center or in government houses, in palaces somewhere, is just not the way to go. We need a real climate deal, and we need it now, not tomorrow. I'm going to take a break. I really enjoyed that ice music. It was fantastic. We could see how by music, a clear illustration of the melting polar ice caps and all that. The only thing we did not see is the spread of the desert. Maybe we should have a sand music next. But brothers and sisters, I want to take a pause. I thank you so much. I thank all the organizers of this event. This is the real event in Copenhagen. Yeah. And so can you just say with me one more time? Say with me. Leave the oil in the soil.
Leave the oil in the soil.
Leave the coal in the hole.
Leave the coal in the hole.
Leave the tar sand in the land.
What is
I thank you for attention.